Well, students, let's proceed with the next set of the questions. Insects that can transmit diseases to humans are referred to as, it's not only an insect, it can be an animal also. Like in case of rabies, it is or bats. What we realize, even the animal is transmitting the disease from infected to the healthy person. So all these, which are the carrier of the disease, are what are they called? Carrier reservoir vectors or incubators, they are called vectors. Vectors are the ones which carry the disease from infected to the healthy person. Next, the vector of the disease, naturally the insect or the mosquito. Sleeping sickness is, we have learned, sand fly is for Kalazar. House fly for waterborne disease like typhoid, cholera, etc. Fruit fly, none. Sessile fly is the one that causes sleeping sickness. So D is the correct option. Next, Alexander Fleming is associated with the discovery of circulation of blood. Circulation of blood was discovered by William Harvey. High law of heredity, that was by Mendel, Gregor John Mendel. Tuberculosis by bacillus, it was discovered by Robert Koch. As a causative agent for tuberculosis. And penicillin was the one that was discovered by Alexander Fleming. That also ended up being called as wonder drug. Because at time when it was discovered, it was the first antibiotic to be discovered. And when it was discovered, it was so widely used by the medical practitioners that for whatever disease is, particularly if it is caused by the bacteria, they thought penicillin to be the most possible curative agent or best for the treatment of disease caused by bacteria. So, D is the correct option. Next, female Anopheles mosquito. Female Anopheles mosquito is the vector of dengue fever. Dengue fever is caused by Aedes aegypti. Yellow fever, none. Malaria is caused by the female Anopheles. Because filariasis is caused by the worm, Wuchereria bancrofti. So the correct answer is malaria. But remember, male Anopheles do not transmit malaria. Why? Because they feed on flower nectars. They don't feed on human blood. They feed on flower nectars. And as they are not feeding on the human blood, there is no chance of the transmission of disease from infected person to the healthy person. Next, female Culex mosquito is a vector of malaria. It's a Culex mosquito, not the Anopheles. Filariasis, yes, ringworm is a fungus. It's not a vector. And none. So the correct option is B. Filariasis is the one that is mostly caused by the female Culex mosquitoes, though it is considered to be transmitted by the worm. But still, we take it to be the filariasis one. Elephantiasis. Next. Oncogenes oncogenes are associated with. Here you need to understand, and it's an important part in the modern world, that oncology is a branch of medical science. Which deals with cause, symptoms, signs, treatment of cancer. So when we take genes, genes are the identity factors. That means the genes responsible for cancer. That makes the option C to be the correct one. That oncogenes are the genes associated with the cancer. As oncology is concerned with the study of cancer, so oncogenes are concerned with the genes responsible for the development of the cancer or tumor. Next, which of the following can cause cancer as well as cure it? Depending upon its intensity and use. Can tobacco cause cancer? Yes. But can it treat it? No. UV rays, can they cause cancer? Yes. Can they treat cancer? Yes. A limited intensity of UV rays can treat cancer in what we call as radiotherapy. And an axis can cause cancer. Now, ionized radiation, that means alpha rays, beta rays, and gamma rays produced on the radioactive decay. Can they cause cancer? Yes. Can they treat cancer? Yes. Alcohol is not possible. So alcohol and tobacco is out. Now we are left with B and C. Both have got capability of causing the cancer and treating the cancer. But ionized radiation is a controlled one. It's human controlled. We can control the emission of the intensity of the radiations. And hence, C is considered to be more a positive answer than B. So it is ionized radiations that can cause the cancer if they are more or uncontrolled, and if controlled, they can be used to treat the cancer or treat the cancer in the early stages. That is the particularly the benign cancer. Cancers that do not transmit, get transmitted from one body part to another. Right? So, C is the correct option. Next. Typhoid and cholera are typical examples of infectious diseases. Yes, they are infectious. Airborne diseases, they are not. They are not transmitted by air. Waterborne diseases, yes. That's the correct answer. Because infectious disease can be airborne, waterborne, vectorborne, etc. And among these infectious diseases, typhoid and cholera are the waterborne diseases. So, though infectious disease is also correct, waterborne is more correcter, is more correct than the A, infectious disease. So, C is the correct option. Next. Blood cancer is commonly known as leukoderma, leukemia, hemophilia, anemia. Anemia is shortage. Of iron and RBC. Hemophilia is a genetic disorder. anyway, the blood failed to clot properly. Now we are left with leukoderma and leukemia. Leukoderma, derma means skin surface. While the development of blood cells take place in the bone marrow. So, A is also not. The correct option is B. That is, in leukemia, that is the blood cancer, the blood cells fails to develop in proper required number in bone marrow. And there are a number of reasons for this non-development or immature development of blood cells or insufficient development of blood cells in bone marrow. And what are the possible case cause is considered as a cause of the blood cancer. It can be hereditary or it can be acquired because of one reason or another, including the radiations. Next, which among the following is a rich source of vitamin A? Vitamin A, you know, deficiency causes night blindness. Or development of white hot spot. That is white opaque spot in the eye, or xerophthalmia. Now, which of the following the best source? Is it rice that contains starch, lemon contains citric acid, brinjal contains minerals like magnesium, etc.? It is the carrot, because fruits and vegetables, yellowish in color, are rich sources of vitamin A. Those that are red in color are rich in iron or aluminium. Right. Next. Which of the following is most injurious to the growing population of India? Injurious, that means causing number of diseases or making the person to suffer from number of diseases. Large number of the people to suffer from the diseases. Is it opium, datura, ganja or tobacco? Actually, all four are infectious. Because datura contains alkaloids, although some of those are useful too. But opium, ganja and tobacco, all three are harmful, deadly harmful. But looking at the population, the percent of the population using them, the tobacco is considered as more a threat because the tobacco in different form is being smoked or is being chewed by people, by public. In one way or other, right? So the correct option is D. Next, which source has been particularly fruitful in finding novel, that is good anti-tumor agent, that means anti-cancerous agents, such as bryostatins and dolostatins? Where is the source of these statins? Marine sources, animals, venoms and toxins. Venom means poisons. Combinatorial chemistry, that means they are being synthesized in chemistry labs. If we look at it, it has been found that bryostatins and the dolostatins are the rich sources from marine. The marine sources are some of the sources of marine animals. Are the ones that contains the high percentage of bryostatins and dolostatins that are used as drugs in the treatment of cancer. Next, If waste material contaminate the source of drinking water, waste material that is excreta or sewage water, which of the following disease will spread? Scurvy. Scurvy is a water deficiency disease. So it can't be. Malaria is a female anopheles infected disease. That is a vector-borne disease. Anemia is iron deficiency. So the waste material disease is the waterborne disease, which is none but is the typhoid. Waterborne. In place of typhoid, if it is cholera, it can also be jaundice, because all these three are the major but common waterborne diseases. Next, which of the following is used in treatment of cancer? These days, electrotherapy, that means giving the electrical shocks, which is not there. It is used mostly for the people suffering from mental disorders. Psychotherapy, this means having some understanding problem, that is suffering from psychological problems. Chemotherapy, that is using the chemicals of physiotherapy. Physiotherapy means exercising, carrying out the different type of exercise, the physiotherapy. So we are left with only chemotherapy. That is using the pills, capsules, injections, syringes, etc. that we use in the treatment of cancer these days. Next, interferons are synthesized in response to mycoplasma, fungi, virus, or bacteria. The correct option is viruses, because what are interferons is that if it is a cell, here is another cell. There is a colony of cells like this. If suppose a cell, this cell, get infected with virus, then what happens? Interferons, the protective layers, are produced on the surface of the adjoining cells. These protective surfaces produced on the surface of the adjoining cells of the infected cell, infected virus, is what we call as interferons. It doesn't happen with bacteria. If a bacteria has invaded in a cell, the rest of the cell will not undergo any change. They will remain as it is. Whereas if a virus has infected a cell, then the surrounding cells, they start producing a protective layer in order to prevent the entry of this virus into them. And that protective form of layer, which is made up of proteins, is what is concerned as interferons. Interferons means interference, layer causing the interference in the entry of the virus into the cell. Am I right? So, see the correct option. Which of the following disease in humans can spread through air? That is disease which is airborne. Airborne disease spread through air. Air means? Dengue is by vector, mosquito. AIDS is by physical contact or body fluid. Goiter is iodine deficiency. So what are we left with? Tuberculosis. Tuberculosis is one of the major airborne disease. And the disease found to be the one responsible for the maximum number of the death worldwide. The maximum number of the death caused because of infectious disease is because of the tuberculosis. And there is a reason for that. The people who are suffering from AIDS are more prone, are more exposed to getting tuberculosis than the other diseases. and end up terminating their life slowly but naturally. Next, the disease which has been eradicated. That means there is no one. Eradication of the disease means the disease which is not found in any person worldwide. And according to WHO, the smallpox has been completely eradicated from the world. That means at one time smallpox, which was the major viral infectious disease in the mankind, among the mankind, is no more there in any person. In same fashion, if we look at the veterinary disease, recently Rinderpest is a fowl disease. That means, fowls means the birds. In poultry. These two diseases, Rinderpest as a bird disease and the smallpox as a human disease, are the two diseases which, according to WHO, have completely been eradicated. Same thing, as you know, there is a pulse program. Going on in India for in fight against polio. Actually, WHO is sponsoring this program along with the government of India in order to eradicate the polio from the polio infection from the child. And maybe we expect that in the years to come, polio may also get eradicated completely from the world, like smallpox. Next, which one of the following is sex-linked disease? Sex-linked means disease is transmitted because of sexual contact. Is it leprosy? No, leprosy is the one in which the body organs start degenerating. Tuberculosis is not a sex-linked disease, it's an airborne disease. Colorblindness is the one which is sex-linked disease because it's a sex-linked disease that passes from the parents to offspring because of the defective gene in the sex chromosome, on the X chromosome, the X and Y chromosome. The X chromosome is the carrier of defective gene. So, color blindness, it can be red-green color blindness, blue-yellow color blindness. There are different forms of color blindness, though red and green color blindness is very common type of the color blindness observed in the people suffering from this disease, but is a sex-linked disease. Next, in context of the genetic disorders, consider the following. Now, these are the questions are the ones that are very, very important. So, the understanding of these questions is very important. Let's see. Consider the following. A woman suffers from color blindness. While her husband does not suffer from it, a woman is suffering from color blindness. A woman can suffer. A mother has got XX. Father has got XY. Mother will suffer from the color blindness when both the X chromosome are the carrier of the defective gene. Now, father is normal, that means the X chromosome is not carrying the disease. They have a son and a daughter. A son and a daughter. In this context, which one of the following statement is probably correct? before we look into the options for such questions, we carry out the cross that mother is XCXC, father is XYXY. If X and XC, XCX, in none of the case, the daughter, which is for the daughter, will be suffering from the disease. She will be the carrier. That means, will be carrying the gene for color blindness, but will not show any symptom of the disease. Now, when we say Y, then XCY, XCY. In both cases, whatever the ovum or whatever the sperm carrying Y chromosome fuses would result in its son who would be suffering from color blindness, because the males are the carrier of XY chromosome. There is only X chromosome. Any defective gene on X chromosome is going to show itself, is going to exhibit or project itself. So, in this case, the daughter born would be normal physically, but aside, the son born would be diseased from the color blindness. Now look, both children suffer from the color blindness? No. Daughter suffer from color blindness? Not son? No. Both children do not suffer from the disease? No. Son suffers from the color blindness, but not daughters. Is the correct option. Because according to my cross, here, the son would be XCY, XCY, the carrier of disease with Y chromosome, carrier of disease with the Y chromosome. But here it is carrier of disease X with normal Y, X. So the normal X will dominate over the carrier. And hence the daughter will not suffer from the disease. So that's how you need to carry out the questions or answer these questions. Next. A colorblind person cannot distinguish black and yellow, red and green, yellow and white, green and blue. Although there are a number of choices of the color blindness are there, but the most common of these is the red and green. That a child, a person if suffering from the color blindness, he probably will be suffering from red and green color blindness. That means will fail to distinguish between red and green color. And such disorders are found using the Ishihara cards. That means these are cards like the circular brown and small patches, circles of different colors. And the infected child, when he is exposed, if he is suffering from red and green color blindness, either he would consider or the green as red or the red as green, and will therefore miscount the red and the green dots. And therefore, such people suffering from the red and green color blindness are advised not to ever drive. Because if they drive, then worldwide, the road crossings, four-way crossings, they have got the red and green lights. So if a person is suffering from red and green color blindness, then he will not be able to distinguish the color of the light, whether it's red or green. Right. Next. Color blindness is related with defect in rod cell, cone cells, eye muscle, all of the above. Color blindness, the color in the eye, in retina we have rod cells and cone cells. Rod cells are for dim light. And in dim light we can't distinguish color. Either is black or white. It is the cone cells which gives us a sensation of color. And hence, the answer is cone cells. The ear muscles, which are the ciliary muscles, they only help change the focal length of the eye lens to focus the image on retina. Right? So, see the correct option. Next, hemophilia a disease in which the blood fails to clot in time. Either it does not clot or it takes time, a longer time to clot. And it is a genetic disorder. That means it passes from parents to offspring. Dominant autosomal gene, it can't be a dominant autosomal gene because hemophilia is a sex-linked disorder. So, option A is incorrect. Recessive autosomal autosomal, whether dominant or recessive, doesn't matter because hemophilia is a sex-linked. It can be recessive sex-linked genes or dominant sex-linked gene. Which one is the one responsible for it? Recessive or dominant? It is a dominant one. Had it been male, it can be both recessive and dominant. But now we are not given any sex, male or female. So we have to take the dominant one. Because a female would show hemophilia when both the X chromosomes are carrying the genes. Male will show hemophilia when only one is carrying. So this is hemophilic son and this is hemophilic daughter. If the daughter is like this, then she is carrier, not deceased. Right, so D is the correct option. Next. Which of the following genetic disease is sex-linked? Royal hemophilia, why? Because this hemophilia disease has been linked with the royal family. Of England. That is the family of Queen Elizabeth. The members of this family have, some of these members of this family suffer from this disease of hemophilia. Tay-Sachs disease, cystic fibrosis, hypertension. Hypertension is not a genetic disorder. Cystic fibrosis, autosomal. Tay-Sachs disease is also, this also called as cat cry syndrome. Is again an autosomal. These both are autosomal. That means they are caused by autosomes. As you are aware that in our body, there are two types of chromosomes. Sex chromosomes and autosomes. Sex chromosomes are related with the sex and the sex-linked characters. Autosomes are concerned with all the characters other than sex and sex-linked characters. And royal hemophilia is the one that is associated with the X chromosome. And hence, is the correct option. Next. Which one of the following is not correct about Down syndrome? Down syndrome is what we call as trisomy. Of 21st chromosome. That in a normal person, what happens is we have got total of 46. That is 44 plus XY of 44 plus XX. This is boy and girl or male or female. But in a case of that Down syndrome, It is 45, 45 instead of 44. That means the 21st pair instead of two chromosomes has got three. Now, this disease in which the child face is round, looks like a just moon shape. There are number of the cases. It is a genetic disorder, yes. It passes from parents to offspring. To offsprings. Affected individuals are early aging. Affected person mental retardation, they are mentally retarded. They cannot speak properly, they cannot understand properly. Affected person has got furrowed tongue. Furrowed tongue means the tongue is not like this. Their tongue, if you look, is slightly furrowed in the front, like the tongue of a frog or of a lizard. Individual early aging is not a symptom or the condition for the Down syndrome, because even the people suffering from Down syndrome can live up to 60 years or more. So this is incorrect. Incorrect with respect to Down syndrome. So is the correct option. Next. Match the item of list 1 with the relevant discoverer in the list 2. That means there is a disease and there is a name of a scientist who is one way or other related to that disease. Smallpox. Smallpox, also the cowpox. With which the Edward Jenner discovered the first vaccine or produced the vaccine. Streptomycin, rabies vaccine, polio vaccine. It's from your understanding point of view, I'm doing it. Polio vaccine, we studied that is produced by John Salk. Rabies vaccine was produced by Louis Pasteur. So, streptomycin with Waksman. So, for A, correct option is what? C. For B, the correct option is D. For C, correct option is A. For D, correct option is B. Right? Now, in this case, what may do they do is that in a question they may place incorrectly any one of the scientists or deceased. And may ask you to find the correct one or the incorrect one. That's how they can manipulate the questions with respect to the disease, vaccines, or the discoverer of the vaccine, or the symptoms. That's how you need to be careful and about those questions that we discussed with the sex-linked diseases, in which a large paragraph is given. In that large paragraph, read the question, subject of the question very carefully. And follow the cross. Once you have done the cross, then you read the options. Because the cross in itself will give you the answer. And that answer you get will match one of the four options given to you. The same thing you might have done in the case of the blood groups. That father has got blood group A, mother has got blood group B. What is the possible blood group of the offspring? What we do is, first we do the cross. And find the possible number of the blood groups among the offsprings, and from there onwards we shift to the options and we find the correct answer as it is. Right? So these were some of the questions that have been so far asked with respect to the health and disease that we have completed in three sets. It's almost about 120 questions and above we have discussed, and with the hope that most of the things are clear with you now with respect to the health and disease, and the rest you can just practice and go over and check your choices, your selections given the health books, different health books that are out there in the market with respect to your examinations. Thank you, and have a nice time.